Hello. In this lecture, we'll learn about the structure of matter and how energy is stored in atoms. There are many topics in astronomy that I love to think about, but light is particularly fascinating. Across the vast emptiness of space, radiation from the stars travels to us on Earth, where we're able to detect and interpret it. The light we see actually originates from the teeny tiny atoms within these enormous stars. Today, we're going to learn the physics of how we get light from atoms. To be able to decode the messages carried by light about distant celestial objects, we need to first understand the nature of matter. The ancient Greek philosopher Democritus wondered what would happen if he could break a piece of matter, like a rock, into smaller and smaller pieces. He thought that perhaps the rock would eventually break into particles so small that nothing smaller could be possible. He called these particles atoms, a Greek term meaning indivisible. Democritus assumed that all materials were composed from four basic elements: fire, water, earth, and air, and that the properties of different elements could be explained by the physical characteristics of their atoms. He was wrong, certainly, but he was on the right track. All ordinary matter is indeed composed of atoms, but we know now that atoms are not indivisible. They are, in fact, composed of even smaller particles. Each element in the periodic table is a different type of atom, and there are over 100 unique chemical elements that have been identified. So let's talk a bit about atomic structure. At the very center of every atom is a tiny nucleus consisting of positively charged protons and neutral neutrons. The negatively charged electrons surround the nucleus in what we call the electron cloud. Most of the atom's mass is in the nucleus, but it's the electron cloud that gives the atom its apparent size. The electron cloud is much, much larger than the nucleus. Really, really much larger. If you imagine an atom on a scale where the nucleus is blown up to be about the size of your fist, then the electron cloud is about the size of downtown Washington, D.C. An element is defined by the number of protons in its nucleus. Hydrogen, for example, always has one proton. Helium always has two protons. Lithium, three, and so on, all the way through the periodic table. And here is some additional atomic terminology. The number of protons in the nucleus is called the atomic number and is denoted by the letter Z. The atomic number for hydrogen, for example, with its one proton, is 1. Helium has two protons, so the atomic number Z is equal to 2. Carbon has six protons, so Z for carbon is equal to 6. The number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus is called the atomic mass number and is denoted by the letter A. Hydrogen has just one proton and no neutrons, so its atomic mass number is 1. Helium has two protons and two neutrons, so its atomic mass number A is equal to 4. Carbon has six protons and six neutrons, so A is equal to 12. Versions of an element with different numbers of neutrons are called isotopes of that element. For example, carbon always has six protons, but it can have different numbers of neutrons. The most common isotope of carbon has six neutrons. The atomic mass number is therefore 12. We call this isotope carbon-12. Carbon can also have seven neutrons. This isotope is called carbon-13. Carbon with eight neutrons is called carbon-14. The number of different material substances in the world is far greater than the number of chemical elements because atoms can combine to form molecules. The chemical properties of molecules can be quite different from those of its individual atoms. For example, molecular oxygen behaves very differently from atomic oxygen, and water behaves very differently from pure hydrogen or pure oxygen. Now that we have some background, we can get to the nitty-gritty of how celestial objects emit light from their atoms. The key idea is that the emission of light originates from the electrons in the atoms of the object. The energy stored in electrons in atoms has a strange but very important property. The electrons can have only particular amounts of energy and no other energies in between. It's like a bookshelf. You can put a book on any shelf you want, but it doesn't make sense to have a book in between the shelves. The possible energies of electrons in atoms are like the possible places you can put a book on a bookshelf. The possible energies are known as energy levels of an atom. This figure shows the energy levels of hydrogen. The energy levels are labeled on the left in numerical order and on the right in energy units called electron volts, or EV for short. The lowest possible energy level, called level 1 or the ground state, is defined as having an energy of 0 electron volts. Each of the higher energy levels is labeled with the extra energy of an electron in that level compared to an electron in the ground state. An electron can move from a lower energy level to a higher one, like this, or it can go from a higher level to a lower one, like this. But an electron cannot go in between levels. The only allowed changes in energy are those corresponding to a transition between energy levels. The electron can jump only if it is given exactly the right amount of energy. To get the electron to jump from level 1 to level 2, 10.2 electron volts and only 10.2 electron volts will do it. 9 electron volts wouldn't be enough, and 11 electron volts would be too much. For the electron to go from level 2 to level 3, exactly 1.9 electron volts are what's needed. If the electron jumps from a higher level to a lower level, the atom must give up energy. The energy released is in the form of light, or a photon. The energy of the emitted photon will be exactly equal to the energy difference between the energy levels. An electron dropping from level 2 to level 1 emits a 10.2 eV photon. The energy levels of an electron in an atom are said to be quantized, and the study of energy levels of electrons and other particles is called quantum mechanics. We'll talk more about quantum mechanics later in the semester. Electrons have quantized energy levels in all atoms, not just hydrogen. And every element has a unique set of energy levels, like bookshelves with different spacings between the shelves. Even molecules have unique energy levels. Next time, we'll see how the different energy levels of different atoms and molecules allow light to carry fingerprints that can actually tell us the chemical composition of faraway celestial objects. It's amazing and beautiful, and I can't wait to tell you all about it. Take care, and I will talk to you soon.